Hello everybody and welcome to this channel. In this episode I'm going to introduce to you a magnificent tourist attraction in Turkey. Please stay tuned. Dolmabahçe Palace, located in the Beşiktaş district of Istanbul, Turkey, graces the European shores of the Bosporus Strait and served as the main administrative center of the Ottoman Empire for decades. Dolmabahçe Palace was constructed between 1843 and 1856 at the behest of the Sultan Abdulmajid I. The construction of this architectural gem incurred a significant expense amounting to 5 million Ottoman gold liras, which was financed through taxation and foreign loans. However, this financial strain exacerbated the Ottoman Empire's precarious fiscal condition. From its inauguration in habitation in 1856 until the dissolution of the Caliphate in 1924, six sultans called this palace home, with the final royal occupant being Caliph Abdulmajid Effendi. Subsequently, a legislative decree in 1924 transferred ownership of the palace to the national heritage of the newly formed Turkish Republic. Originally, the site of Dolmabahçe graced the Bosporus as a bay and a berth for the Ottoman fleet. Gradually reclaimed during the 18th century, it evolved into an imperial garden cherished by Ottoman sultans. It is from this garden that the name Dolmabahçe, meaning field garden in Turkish, derives its significance. Over time, various small summer palaces and wooden pavilions adorned the landscape, culminating in the creation of the Beşiktaş Waterfront Palace Complex. Confined within an area of 110,000 square meters, the palace is flanked by the Bosporus to the east and a steep precipice to the west. Dolmabahçe stands as Turkey's grandest palace, boasting an expansive area of 45,000 square meters comprising 285 rooms, 46 halls, 6 baths and 68 lavatories. The architectural design is a fusion of Baroque, Rococo and neoclassical styles, harmonized with traditional Ottoman architecture, reflecting the evolving influence of European aesthetics during the Tanzimat period. Notably, the exterior facade, particularly when viewed from the Bosporus, presents a classical European two-wing structure divided by a prominent avant-corps. While embracing European design elements, the palace also preserves traditional Ottoman and Turkish architectural features. Functionally segregated, the southern wing houses public representation rooms, while the northern wing serves as the private residence for the Sultan and his family. The ceremonial hall, a majestic space spanning 2,000 square meters with a soaring 36-meter high dome, serves as the focal point separating these two functional sections. Reflecting the necessity for seclusion, the harem, a quintessential feature of Middle Eastern architecture, comprising 8 interconnected apartments for the royal family, is situated in a separate part. The opulence of Dolmabahce is manifested in its lavish adornments. 14 tons of gold gild the ceilings and other parts of the palace. The pièce de résistance, the ceremonial hall, boasts the world's largest chandelier adorned with 750 lamps and weighing 4.5 tons. Additionally, Dolmabahce boasts the world's most extensive collection of Bohemian and Baccarat crystal chandeliers. The iconic crystal staircase, crafted from Baccarat crystal, brass, and mahogany, adds to the palace's grandeur. The palace's interior is further embellished with rare stones such as marble, Egyptian alabaster, and porphyry from Pergamon City. A profusion of carpets adorn the main hall alongside bearskin rugs gifted to the Sultan. Notably, the palace showcases a curated collection of oil paintings by renowned artists. By passing time, Dolmabahce has been equipped with amenities including gas lights, water closets, later on electricity, central heating, and an elevator. Rooms extending from the main entrance hall overlook both the sea and the land. Sea-facing rooms accommodated prominent Ottoman officials such as the Grand Vizier, while land-facing rooms housed palace administrators and estate functionaries. Adjacent to the palace, there are two outstanding structures: a Baroque-style mosque commissioned by Queen Mother Bismillah Sultan, which was built between 1853 and 1855, in addition to a clock tower erected at the behest of Sultan Abdul Hamid II between 1890 and 1895, that is situated in front of the Imperial Gate alongside the European waterfront of the Bosporus. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Let me know your opinion in the comments section, and if you would like, please subscribe to my channel and wait for new videos.